Good morning, my dear children. I am Jitin, your English teacher. I am here after 10 days. I hope all of you are safe at home. Are you all getting bored by staying at home? Anyway, let's try to make this class interesting. All of you listen to me. And before I begin, let me remind you one thing. Be safe at home. Be safe. Today we will learn the third chapter, that is the dream. Do you know what is dreaming? All of us dream. When do we dream? When we sleep, we see dreams. Don't you see a boy in the picture? He is sleeping and he is also dreaming. Likewise, we also dream. Today we will study about the dream of a person. So the name of the chapter is The Dream. So shall we start? Don't you see a man in the picture? He is a priest. P-R-I-E-S-T, priest. Priest is a person who works in the temples. So this priest is the hero of the story. Now we shall start the story. All of you look at your textbook and read with me. Once there was a priest. He was poor. He was also lazy and did not want to work. But he wanted to get rich. He got his food by begging in the village. Now listen to me. Once upon a time, there was a priest. He was a poor person, but he was lazy, L-A-Z-Y, lazy. Lazy means he did not do any work. He was lazy all the time. But the priest wanted to become rich. He was poor, but he wanted to become rich. Without doing any work, how can he become rich? Anyway, how did he get food? All of us need food, no? He got his food by begging in the village. Now look at the picture. Don't you see a plate in the hands of priest? There is some rice in the plate. What does it mean? The priest goes to each home and asks for rice. He got his food by begging in the village. One day, someone gave the priest a pot of milk. Now look at the picture. There is a pot in the hands of the priest. Pot means the vessel used for collecting water. The priest has a pot and there is milk in the pot. One day, someone gave the priest a pot of milk. Now look at the face of the priest. He got a pot of milk and he is very happy, isn't it? The priest is very happy. Why? Because he got a pot of milk. He was happy and hurried back home. He hung up the pot and lay down to rest. As his eyes closed, he dreamt. He dreamt that he would make butter from the milk. Then he would heat it to get ghee. He would sell the ghee and get a lot of money. Now listen to me. The priest got a pot of milk and he was very happy. He was very happy and he hurried back home. H-U-R-R-I-E-D, hurried. Hurried means he went back home very fast. He was happy because he got a pot of milk and he went to the home very fast. He hung up the pot and lay down to rest. He hung up the pot, H-U-N-G, hang up. Hang up means to hang the pot. Look at the picture. The boat is hanging. He hung up the boat and he lay down to rest. That means he laid on his bed for sleeping. After some time, he closed his eyes and he went into sleeping. Then he had a dream. What did he dream? He dreamt that he would make butter from the milk. There is milk in the pot, no? The priest dreamt that the priest would make butter from the milk. Then he would heat the butter and he would make ghee. Then he would make lot of money. Now listen to me. What did he dream? He dreamt that he would make butter from the milk. And after heating butter, he would make ghee. Then he would sell the ghee and make lot of money. We continue. With that money, he would buy a hen. The hen would lay eggs and there would be more cocks and hens. The hens would lay hundreds of eggs and soon he would have a poultry farm. His dream continued. He would sell the hens and buy cows. There would be a dairy farm. He would sell all the milk and become very rich. Now listen to me. The priest laid down for sleeping and he had a dream. What did he dream? He dreamt that he would make butter from the milk and by heating butter, he would make ghee. He would sell the ghee and make a lot of money. With that money, he would buy a chicken. And what will happen? Look at the picture. The chicken would lay many eggs and there would be many more chicken. All this chicken will give him plenty of eggs and there would be many cocks and many hens, and with all these hens and with all these cocks, what would he do? He would start a poultry farm. P-O-U-L-T-R-Y, poultry. Poultry farm. What is the meaning of poultry farm? Poultry farm means a house where there are many chicken, where there are many hens, where there are many cocks for making eggs. And by starting this poultry farm, he would make lot of money. He would sell all the hens and he would make lots of money. And what would he do? With this money, he would buy cows. The cows give what? The cows give milk. He would make lot of milk from the cows and he would sell the milk. He would make lots of money and he would become very rich. His dream is continuing. We continue. Then he would buy jewels. The king would buy his jewels and give him a lot of money. When he would become the richest man in the land, he would marry a beautiful girl. They would have a handsome son. If the son was naughty, the priest would beat him with a stick. In his dream, he picked up a stick to hit the boy. But it was a real stick and it hit the pot. Now listen to me. The priest had a dream that he would have a poultry farm and by making much money from the poultry farm, he would buy cows and he would start a dairy farm. What is a dairy farm? Dairy farm is a place where there are plenty of cows for making milk. He would make plenty of milk from the dairy farm and he would make lot of money. And then what he would do? He would buy jewels. J-E-W-E-L-S. Jewels. What are jewels? Jewels are ornaments. Jewels are precious stones. They are very valuable. By making much money from the milk. He would buy jewels. And what would happen? The king would purchase his jewels and he would make many more money. Then what would happen? He would become the richest man in the land. When he becomes the richest man in the land, he would marry a beautiful girl. Then what would happen? The beautiful girl and the priest would have a handsome son. If the son was naughty, the priest would beat him. Our parents beat us now, like that. If the son was naughty, the priest would beat him. So the priest took a stick while he was sleeping. And don't you see a stick in the hands of the priest in the picture? Look at the picture. The priest is taking a stick and he is beating his boy. So he would take a stick and beat the son if he was naughty. So the priest took a stick and he beat the son. But he was actually dreaming. The stick was real. He took a real stick and he beat somewhere. He thought that it is his son. He beat somewhere with the stick. And where did he beat? He beat the pot. Don't you remember? In the beginning, the priest hanged the pot. The pot had milk in it. The priest took the stick and beat somewhere. He beat the pot. And what would happen? Let us see what would happen. The pot broke into tiny pieces. All the milk was spilled. The priest woke up from his sleep. He realized that he had fallen asleep while daydreaming. Now look at the picture. What happened? The priest took a stick while he was dreaming and he beat his son. But it was not his son. It was the pot. And what happened? The pot broke down. There was milk in the pot, no? The milk was spilled. All the milk was spilled. The pot broke down because the priest beat the pot. And the milk was spilled. The priest woke up from his sleep. And the priest understood that he beat the pot, not his son. All the milk was spilled. He understood that. And look at the picture. He is very sad. Isn't it? Now let us conclude the chapter. There was a priest. The priest was poor. He got his food by begging. One day he got a pot of milk. Then he hanged the pot and he slept. He had a dream. He had a dream that he made butter from the milk. Then from the butter he made ghee. He sold the ghee and made some money. He bought a chicken. The chicken gave him an egg. Then after getting some eggs, there were many hens and cocks. Then he started a poultry farm. He made lot of money. Then from that money, he started a dairy farm with a lot of cows. He made many more money. Then with that money, he bought jewels. The king purchased his jewels. He made lot of money. And when he was the richest person in the land, he married a beautiful girl. Then he had a handsome son. The son did something naughty. The priest took a stick and beat him. But it was not his son. It was the milk pot. The pot broke down and all the milk was spilled. Now let us study some words. Study the spelling and you try to study the meaning. The first word is priest. P-R-I-E-S-T. Priest. Priest is a person who performs religious rituals. The second word is lazy. L-A-Z-Y. Lazy means not ready to do any work. The third word is begging. B-E-G-G-I-N-G, begging. Begging means ask for something, especially for food. The fourth word is hurry back. H-U-R-R-Y-B-A-C-K, hurry back. Hurry back means going back very fast. The fifth word is poultry farm. P-O-U-L-T-R-Y, poultry. Poultry farm is a farm where birds are kept for egg and meat. The sixth word is dairy farm. D-A-I-R-Y, dairy. Dairy farm is a place that has cows and produces milk. The seventh word is jewels. J-E-W-E-L-S, jewels. Jewels means valuable stones. The eighth word is beautiful. B-E-A-U-T-I-F-U-L, beautiful. The ninth word is handsome. H-A-N-D-S-O-M-E, handsome. The tenth word is naughty. N-A-U-G-H-T-Y, naughty. Naughty means having bad behavior. So if you are naughty means you have bad behavior. The 11th word is tiny, T-I-N-Y. Tiny means very small. The 12th word is spill, S-P-I-L-L, spill. Spill means liquid is overflowing. The 13th word is realize, R-E-A-L-I-Z-E, realize. Realize means to become aware of or to understand something. All of you read the textbook very well and try to understand the story. It is an interesting story. There is so much of fun in it. Try to understand it. Study the words I have given very well. Study the spelling and try to understand the meaning. We can see in the next class. Bye all. Thank you.